I'm John Green. Well, not really. I'm replacing him to talk about the amazing Industrial Revolution. But before we get started, let's roll the intro. So, you probably have some knowledge of the Industrial Revolution. We made pretty things, and then we changed the world, and now we run on rainbows and live happily ever after, right? No. Oh, and there was so much more happening than just the whole invention part and the Industrial Revolution. But we'll get to that in a minute. Just the Industrial Revolution started in 1760 in Great Britain. During this time, people just cut down their trees and built their own homes. But as you can imagine, it became very boring and time-consuming. It led to people asking for more. Big shocker, am I right? I mean, you know. Anyways, there's far more information and facts about humans just coming up and creating things. It's a dark history with war, illnesses, and death, of course. While coal was a revolutionary discovery itself, there was still so much more to come with introducing coal into our world. The Industrial Revolution began in Great Britain for many reasons, such as shortage of wood, system of free enterprise, and the government supported the project, so... Cotton was produced by slaves, which was also the rule of law. People from all around Europe and England and all those places around Great Britain actually came to Britain to see how the mechanics were made and how they worked, and then they would go home and use those ideas for their own mechanics. The first countries that had mechanics after Britain were Belgium, Switzerland, France, and the state that became Germany. Soon after, they installed a railroad system as part of the industrialization, but that's a whole long explanation thing, so we're not going to get into that in this part because I only have 5 minutes, so thank you, Mr. Thompson. The revolution ended up entering neighboring countries such as America in 1790, and then Belgium in its railroads in 1834. And then France in 1842, and then Switzerland in 1847, and Germany in the 1850s. Oh, I think the open compartment's ready! Let's go look. Oh, the good old light bulb. You know, we wouldn't have the light bulb without Joseph Swan, or Thomas Edison, or James Watt.
Adeline, who's James Watt?
Well, beautiful, gorgeous, hot future self who is also disguised as my sister. That's a great question, and I'm going to tell you. James Watt was born in Scotland in 1736. He got most of his education from his father's workshop. When Watt was 18, he decided to become a maker of mathematical instruments. In 1769, James Watt invented a more powerful and efficient steam engine. In 1776, Watt and his business partner, Matthew Boulton, installed a steam engine with separate condensers. The modified steam engine not only reduced waste, but it also cut the cost of fuel. The industrialization began in the United States when Samuel Slater... Beautiful, I know.
It is also 1 a.m. currently, and I completely forgot about this man, and I just realized I had to put him in the video. So now I have to go find a photo of him. Okay, back to the video.
AKA Father of the Industrial Revolution, Father of the American Industrial Revolution, I should say. He immigrated from Britain to Rhode Island in 1789 and set up the first textile factory in the United States. The first textile factory that he set up was in the United States oil, so it was on their land of oil. Modified steam engine not only reduced waste, but it also cut fuel costs. He ended up leaving Britain with no plans, no writing down notes, no nothing. He did all of that from memory. Okay, now to the thought bubble.
So we know the backstory about the Industrial Revolution, but if you really think about it, the revolution wouldn't have never started without coal. We probably wouldn't be this advanced without it. Since coal was available, it provided the resources we needed to start the engine, like the steam engine. Plus, if the wood disaster never happened, we also wouldn't be here. So I just want to say thank you for using up all the wood so that we can now be where we are with electricity and technology and things as such. Okay, back to learning.
Thank you, Thought Bubble. Moving on. The American Civil War, which lasted from 1861 to 1865, it was the first true industrial war. Francis Cobalt Wall started and created the first fast and dependable power loom in 1813. By the 1900s, the United States had overtaken Britain in manufacturing, providing 24% of the world's output. Factory workers often worked 13 hours without any legal rights. In the 1800s, Europeans controlled about 34% of the world's, or the land surface, of the world. By 1914, it was 84%. Britain led the 19th century takeovers and ended the century with the largest non-contagious empire the world has ever known. The sun never sets on the British Empire, as the British like to say. There were many consequences to the revolution. For example, 35,000 people died a year during this time. So if you do the math, I don't know how much that would be. I didn't do the math. So you do the math.
Okay, for some reason I did the math. And that would be 140,000 people in that time span. Okay, thank you.
500,000 people were injured over this time. The Second Industrial Revolution lasted from the mid-19th century until the early 20th century and took place in Britain. Also, during the revolution, the richest man known to live during the revolution was Richard Arkwright. He ended up becoming the richest man, and he's also known as the father of the Industrial Revolution. So it's also probably why he has so much money. Well, I'm sorry, but that is all that we have for today. But thank you so much for watching and letting me replace John Green for a day and talking to you about the Industrial Revolution. It's been great learning with all of you. Now to the credits.
What is it now? Is it bloopers? Now to the bloopers.
Some of these scenes contain my 22-year-old sister. Viewer discretion is most definitely advised.
Okay, and type 26. Action.
Known to man and to an individual. It did that.
Yeah. It was one of the most devastating diseases.
I was born for the
Q contagion is you're done. It is spread by a
are you dog contagions?
Yeah.
It's contagious.
It's contagious.
People need to know it's contagious.
You're contagious.
Caused by the vulnerable. The what now? Anyways, time for the open letter. My open letter lady was too late. You died of smallpox.